somehow I'm on my UBI kick. Hopefully this lighting is better. I don't know. We have now Tantriya. Okay, so the last video I was really heavy on how it will reduce the criminal factor. Therefore, of course, it will reduce prison costs, etc., which are just a huge gloat on all of these economies. So that will reduce, you see. So that's major. Okay. But what else? Okay, so here we are, we're having our freedom, we're like getting like this big cash in a way, you know, and it starts piling up in our bank accounts. Even, you know, we each, with my system in particular, you get this $27 every day, and then it accrues, you know, and then after a few weeks it ends up being 500 or whatever. So yeah, so you end up having money to spend. And so these decisions have to be made. You know, a person who didn't have that money before, they didn't have the choice. They can get the electric car, you see. So ecology starts to trickle through as a possible. They can start to buy that makeup that is good for their face, that is not hurtful for to the planet. They can start buying that type of makeup for their face. They can do amazing things. Just making choices at the store, making different choices at the store. Okay, so when they're going in, they can be like, "Well, I now have clout," you know. So, no, it's not going to be equality amongst the people, and maybe that's another fear. Maybe that's why people don't want it. They don't want equality amongst the people. They're afraid the classes will trickle to zilch, and we'll all be equal. In the very beginning of stages of this, no, it's not going to be equality at all. There is going to be people that will always want more. They will always compete more. They will always hype for more. And those ones will be, they're going to elevate themselves regardless, okay? It's the others, you know, it's the others that are really lagging down where we're going, you know what I'm saying? It's the others. Okay, so what else did I get into here? I have the, now we can all purchase electric cars. We can now retrofit our houses with ecological choices. You know, we don't have to buy the cheapest garbage for insulation. You can buy the insulation you really wanted. Let's say you really wanted, well, we can't get the wool now, darn it, because the shearers, they're so aggressive. But if you had a big enough place, you could get the goat, per se. You could get the goat and shear it yourself and stuff your walls. I don't know, but I mean, these choices would be possible now. Don't you get it? You're gonna have a little bit more time. We have, of course, have the impinging robotation that's coming in. The robots are marching in, and everyone keeps saying that's the reason. It's because of the robots. Everything is robotized. We have no work. We can't do this. We can't do that. It's all robotized. And yeah, that is true. With each generation, you know, there's going to be robots there that are going to be competing with you in your work and your job. And so we have to think another way to make a living. That's why I advocate the property sales version. Because even just sitting in a house and becoming house rich is a career. It is a job. It is a work. Okay, so Virantaryantaryam. That's really what we have. We are setting ourselves into the I call it the Venus Project of the future. You know, the Venus Project of the future is is dealing with these issues, dealing with the robots that take our jobs away, that's automized already. We don't need that many workers. So stay away. We don't even ask for you to hire. So those types of things. So yeah, so we have that obviously is a big hit, a big reason for adopting the UBI like ASAP. You know, we've got to get it going. But alternatively, I'm really into what it's going to do to us as a person, to person level, like how we are going to be on a reactive state to other human beings, how we are going to present ourselves to other human beings, how we will be more polite, how, you know, you're not going to walk around with a chip on your shoulder, I've been stricken with being born on the other side of the tracks. That chip is going to subside, it's not going to hurt so much. Okay, so the other side of the tracks people are not going to be so aggressive. And so we have the ruling class, I call them the ruling class. I have a big problem here in this town where I live. It's the ruling class lording over the manual labor. And the manual labor is very comfortable with that. They don't, because they don't want to mix, they don't want to mingle. They prefer you to stay ruling class and they stay the labor. They don't want to have chit-chat and be normal. And hey, this, you know, let's go to the game or the ballpark. They don't want that with you. They don't want that camaraderie. They prefer their distance, because in essence, you know, with this current economy system, the current class system, it's an uncomfortable state, you know, to go hang out with your overlord, who is your employer. You know, they don't want that. You know, you're just the employer. So yeah, so, but here we are. Okay, so we have extra cash, extra money. Choices are going to be made. You can have dance lessons. You can go to the arts. You can go and visit a ballet. You can go to the opera. You can do things that you have never been able to do. Those are going to start lining up for you as a possibility. You're going to be hanging out with a group that goes to the theater. That is a different group altogether. That group has been slowly obliterated here in the United States, but in Europe it is still there. Pretty dense in Germany, but it is one that we have to keep a stronghold of. We have to keep a stronghold of that group. We cannot lose it. We have to fortify it. Okay, so here, so the more of us that have that access, we guess what we're going to do? We're going to go to the theater. We're going to go to the ballets. We're going to go to the operas. We're going to put our children into classes and studies. They're gonna go straight into the classical learning of instruments. All of this is gonna flourish, okay? Because that group, when you go out, okay, this is not just a football game. It's not a football game anymore. You know, there's a quiet down. There's a quiet down that happens when there is that incoming of cash. There is a quiet down event. And there's like, well, no, I don't really want to go blow it at a football game. You know, I'm responsible now. It makes you responsible, doesn't it? It makes you responsible. So here you've got a responsibility now added to that citizen. So the citizen now is doing what? He's like, he or she, they're co-mingling in an audience where they never commingled before. So guess what? They're doing the peer pressure routine. The peer pressure routine is, I see what you're doing, I see how you're acting, I see what you're wearing. They're gonna still be playing that game. that class group is not going away. They're still going to be playing that game. That eye to eye, and here we are in this moment, and this is our effect. And they're going to start to feel important. These new citizens, I'll call them, they're going to start to feel really important. Whereas before, they were forgotten. They were just a 911 phone call, one of those bad boys cop shows. They're going to start to feel really, really like, hey, I may even have a say in this world. I may even matter in the scheme of things. I may be that important. So you have this happening just from the UBI. We're talking a serious uplift of human beings, a serious uplift of the humanity, the compassion state within each human being also. That is going to increase. That is going to fortify. So when you're talking about, hey, we have to save the polar bears off the melting ice, you know, that would be something that maybe all of a sudden their heads would be interested in. Whereas now, they're not. Okay, maybe all of a sudden they'll be like, well, maybe I have an effect, you know. Maybe I am important in that matter. Okay, so saving them off the melting ice is a huge issue. I'm not really sure how we're going to do that. I don't think we are going to be able to. I believe that's just going to be the polar bears dealing with their evolution. And I don't believe we're going to be able to solve it. And if they're going to be gone by the wayside, they're going to be gone by the wayside. The problem with global warming. Obviously, a lot of species will fall. We are dealing with a, what do we call it? Well, we're not all going to be politicians, but we are dealing with a group that is going to just be more, they're going to want to be more educated. I mean, they're just going to want to be, just full stop, they're just going to be interested in it, because guess what, they were in that peer pressure moment even at the arts, and they took their kids to dance class, and they're like, well, that's kind of a neat group of people, and those moms, you know, that take their kids, that's kind of a neat group, you know, they're kind of selective, and so we're going to start feeling more that we are a selected group. And included, okay, so the lower poverty level is going to start to feel included and available to selectivity, that they can make choices, whereas before they couldn't. All right. Where am I going with this now? It was just really about the change of the individuals themselves. Because right now, this planet is in an embarrassing state. Like, if we had visitors, oh my gosh, I would be like so embarrassed to like say, hey, you know, this is it. This is what we have. We have that group over there that vomits in the street and on the subways. And we can't really do anything about them because they're just the, what do we call them, blue-collar workers, and they're just low-life scumbags. We can't do anything about them because they're uneducated, and we can't train them. That would be really embarrassing, wouldn't it, to show them as part of who we are as humanity. I would be like, well, hurry, let's get this UBI before they show up, and then, you know, hey, you know, we'll have a, we'll have stricken that direction off, you know, stricken it off completely. A human being, a human race direction is not going into vomiting on subways anymore. We're just not doing that. we've altered our path. Anyway, so yeah, so that's really where I'm at with it, is the change of the human being.